everyone. Hello, YouTube. We are back again. My name is Jared and you are watching Tito Fit. And in this channel, we like to talk about health, fitness, wellness, and living your best life as the proverbial Tito or Tita. So if you're into that, make sure to watch this video through. Today's video, we are gonna talk about some guidelines when you are tracking calories, tracking macros, if you're into flexible dieting, that kind of thing. We're gonna talk about some things that you should not forget to do so that you maximize the results out of that. So if you're interested in that, please don't forget to give this video a like. Paki-like tong video ngayon na. Alright, and then subscribe na rin kayo kasi we noticed that about 80% of you are not subscribed. So syempre, for those 80% na hindi subscribed na pinapanood nyo naman to, I'm guessing meron naman kayong pakinabang na nakukuha. So pinakamalit na mahihingi lang namin is mag-subscribe kayo sa channel na to. So number one tip, when you're tracking macros, tracking your calories, tracking your food, basically, the first thing that you should remember is to weigh yourself. Okay, how often? As much as possible, every day. If you can't do it every day, weigh yourself about 5 times per week. Bakit? Kasi, generally speaking, nagfa-fluctuate yung weight natin per day depending on how much water you're retaining, how bloated you are, things like that. So it's best to get an average of the 5 weighings na ginawa mo. So it's, halimbawa, nag-weigh ka ng Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Ang gagawin natin is add that all up and divide it by 5. And that is your average weight for the week. At yun ang sundan mo. Huwag mong sundan yung kung ano lang yung lumalabas dun sa 5 numbers na yun. So an average would give you a more accurate representation of your progress from week to week. So it's best to check your progress on a weekly basis. So don't forget to weigh yourself. Find a good scale. Be consistent with that scale. Basically, that means na yun lang ang scale na gagamitin mo. Huwag kang gumamit ng ibang scale pang weigh. The best thing to do is to get a scale, buy a scale, digital, analog, it doesn't really matter. And then put it like right outside your bathroom door or under your bed. And pagkagising na pagkagising mo, that's the first thing you do. Maybe after you go wee-wee. Okay, after you go wee-wee, timbang agad. Number two, with that, so your weight is just one aspect of your snapshot of your progress sa pag-track mo. The next thing is a very, very important thing is yung itsura ng katawan mo. It's not just all about yung timbang mo, pero yung itsura din. So take photos. A good time to take a photo is before you start tracking your macros, or weekly. So weekly, take photos of yourself on the same day, under the same light. So dapat pareho yung ilaw, same mirror if that's what you're doing, if you're taking it under your mirror. Kasi minsan iba-iba rin yung pag-refract ng light sa mirror. So may mga mirror na medyo pabor siya sa itsura mo, may mga mirror na ayaw niya sa'yo. So, okay. So hanapin mo yung mirror na pinaka-type mo. And then take a photo of yourself, snapshot of yourself there regularly. Okay, under the same light conditions. Or ideally, same time of day din. Number three, your daily protein requirement should fall between 0.7 grams of your body weight in pounds and 1. Halimbawa, ang timbang mo is 170 pounds. It would be between 0.7 of that and 1, which is 170 grams, basically. So if your weight is in pounds, you transfer that into grams, that would be your protein intake for the day. Now, don't forget na hindi yun yung timbang ng karne mismo. It's the protein yield. So you have to check for the conversion on an app, a tracking app, calorie tracking app like MyFitnessPal, Carbon Diet Coach, things like that. No? So you would use those apps to determine the amount of protein contained dun sa pagkain na kinakain mo na high protein. If you are in that 0.7 to 1 gram range on a daily basis, over a period of weeks, over a period of months, and are consistent with your training, your body will definitely build more muscle. And definitely, of course, if your body builds more muscle, mas aayos yung itsura natin. Because more muscle will lead to a better physique overall. It'll burn more fat, more calories at rest, things like that. You already know that. We always talk about things like that in our other videos. So definitely hit your protein requirements and set it at that number. And leading to number four, let's say for example that your caloric goal for the day is 2,500 calories, for example. 2,500 calories. And then your protein goal for the day is 170 grams. So you will multiply 170 grams by the number 4 because that is what will yield the calorie content of 170 grams of protein. So 170 times 4. 80. That's 680 calories, if I'm not mistaken. 680 calories in 170 grams of protein. Ibawas mo yung 680 calories sa 2,500 calories na daily requirement mo. And you will end up with about 1,820. Am I right? I think so. 1,820 calories. Ngayon, yung 1,820 calories na yun, divide that between carbohydrates and fat. Up to you na which you prefer. They're okay, just don't go over. Just remember, carbohydrates times 4 din siya sa calories per gram. Sa protein, same sa protein, pero ang fat times 9. Kaya it's very, very too easy to overeat if you are the type who prefers more fatty foods. Kasi they are more calorically dense, or basically, mas marami siyang calories per gram than carb-rich foods or protein-rich foods. So, yun lang yung kailangan nating ingatan doon. So, make sure na kapag sineset mo yun, na dapat pasok ka lagi doon sa 2,500 calories. Pero ang priority mo, syempre, yung protein. Kung medyo kulang ng konti, okay lang yun. Medyo sobra ng konti, okay lang yun. Ang importante is your consistency over a longer period of time. Like, say, 12 weeks, 16 weeks, 6 months, things like that, and definitely 100% you will find na maganda yung resulta na nangyayari sa katawan mo, generally speaking. Of course, kung wala kang mga ibang other underlying problems that are giving you trouble with your metabolism. Number 5 tip, you don't need to track the number of calories that comes from green leafy vegetables or cruciferous vegetables. So ito yung mga like madahon na gulay like kangkong, spinach, pechay, cabbage, or aka repolyo, yung mga ganun. Or cruciferous vegetables like broccoli, cauliflower, asparagus, so things like that. So you don't need to track the number of calories you get from that because they are very, very low in calories, yung mga gulay na yun. Although, wag mong kakalimutan na you have to track kung ano man yung pinangsahog mo dun. Let's say you put ilang tablespoons of oyster sauce, ganun-ganun type kumain, or ilang tablespoons ng toyo kung sa pagluto mo. So you will have to track the condiments, the sauces, yun. Kasi mas may calories pa yun kesa sa, halimbawa, 100 grams of broccoli as probably not even going to be 50 calories. 100 grams of broccoli. And karamihan ng calories pa nun is it contains fiber. So meaning pag containing fiber, it just passes through your body. It helps you be regular, it helps keep things moving. Of course, vegetables will help you live longer in a way because they improve the quality of your health. They're packed with antioxidants, phytonutrients, vitamins and minerals, that kind of thing. Okay? So lahat ng kailangan mo na micronutrients na gagaling sa gulay mostly. Of course, marami rin ang gagaling sa other foods like meats, nuts, seeds. So don't forget to balance your approach when it comes to food sources. And always focus on whole, unprocessed foods for the majority of your diet. Now, ito, extra bonus tip na lang to. Mahirap maabot ang protein requirements coming from whole foods lang, especially the bigger you are. If you're tall, if you have a lot of muscle mass, mahirap siyang abutin. So you really will probably need some type of protein powder, whether that be whey, whether that be pea, or when I mean pea, ano yun, like green peas, not pea as in P-E-E, okay? Don't do that. We're not into that, okay? So hopefully this video helped you guys out, and I hope that you are tracking your macros, especially if you are trying to prepare for something, whether that be something like a photo shoot, or if you're trying to prepare for an event like a race, so you'd probably be in a slight surplus, caloric surplus, and if it's a photo shoot, you'd be in a deficit. Now, don't forget, these tips will work whether you are trying to lose fat or to gain muscle. It doesn't matter, these tips will help you. So, that being said, I will see you in the next one. Let me know in the comments down below. Do you track macros? Have you tried tracking macros? Do you own a food scale pero inaalikabok lang siya dahil hindi mo nagagamit? or kailangan mo ba ng extra tulong or more information kung paano mag-track ng macros, let us know down in the comments below and we will see you guys till the next time. Thank you for helping us reach 6,000 subs. So we're not 6,000, road to 10K. See ya!